Hi, Alex. We've got a front row seat to a history-making day here at the United States Supreme Court. You can see behind me crowds of maybe 1,000 to 2,000 people who have ascended here onto the grounds of the U.S. Supreme Court. We were here at 10 o'clock this morning wondering if this Roe decision would be overturned. And so we're maybe a crowd of about 100, 200 people, very small crowd. And as soon as it happened, cheers went out from one side, tears from the other side. And now the crowd is growing that the police have shut off the grounds to the state capitol. And you can see that the Supreme Court building is surrounded by fencing, too, for security reasons. Both sides of this issue are very upset. Rather, one side is very upset. One side is very happy. We talked to both of them here this morning.
This is unbelievably historic. I have thousands of men and women who came before me who have been fighting this fight who don't get to be here today. I'm only 20 years old. I wasn't here whenever Roe v. Wade happened, but I get to be here today, and for that I'm so grateful, and I owe it to the people who came before me to sit here and celebrate this day and be here.
This is amazing. You know, it's like,
no, and
I just have to thank God. It truly is just
evil, good, and good,
one of the most amazing things
that
happened. I can barely stand.
Right?
I can barely
but
talk
this is
right
good.
Now. It's amazing.
Is right.
Justice is real. Justice is real.
I know for a lot of women, it's a question about their immediate safety and health. Out here in D.C., I know where I'm from in California, a lot of people will still have that access, but people in other states where their rights are being infringed upon and won't have access to this kind of safe health care, it's a question about immediate danger as well. It's a question of what they can do in order to protect their own well-being, to protect their own health, and I can imagine it's very stressful.
We are not going to rest until the U.S. government makes Roe into law. We're calling on the Biden administration, we're calling on Congress, we're calling on Senate to make abortion law. Make abortion law for women across this country, because we deserve the right to bodily autonomy. We have less bodily autonomy than corpses.
And so far here at the U.S. Supreme Court, the protests have been peaceful. Lots of chanting. We apologize. There are many profane signs and some profane chanting going on here because emotions are running very high. The crowd is expected to get much bigger here throughout the day as the news of this spreads across the country. And this is ground zero for where all the protests will be happening here in the country. And we'll be here all day long here covering the protests and to hear from both sides of this very controversial story coming up tonight at 5 and 6. We're live in Washington, D.C. at the Supreme Court building. Todd Magel, KCCI 8 News.